Because of a low ceiling, the LEDs drop somewhat when I move my body down. A downside of this device is that it does not provide a way to do a hands-free electric measurement. You always need to touch the metal output on the side of the device. But it is the only device I know that has a true sound function for electric fields. So this makes it a very desirable device. The LEDs on this device respond quick. The Esmog Spion looks very sensitive to electric fields. The telescopic antenna isn't even extended here. Here is a demo with the telescopic antenna extended. Devices connected to ground are more sensitive, but it is also a different way of measuring. So it is advised to also measure electric fields without ground cable, with devices like these. And then it's best to not hold it in your hand. But for measuring magnetic fields, you can always hold a device in your hand. You can see that these white devices are a lot more sensitive to electric fields when they are grounded. They are now so sensitive that I can't test from zero inside here. I would need to test outside. But this sensitivity is very useful because the point is to get the electric fields as low as possible. I try to measure with both white devices grounded side by side, but I didn't like it. I think the ground cables influenced the results. So if you want to compare the results of a grounded measurement, you will have to skip the video back and forth. These white devices have very likable sound functions. But they aren't true sound functions like the Esmog Spion devices have.